Hello, everyone. My name's Audrey Scanlon. I'm the Bishop of the Episcopal Diocese of Central Pennsylvania. And joining me today is...
Kevin Nichols, the Bishop of the Diocese of Bethlehem.
Yes, and we're back with you. We are trying to put a video forward every month, usually towards the beginning of the month in our Friday video slot, to talk about the continuing discernment work for reunification. So we're good to see you, Kevin. And we have something to talk about today that I think is really exciting. We've put together in the last couple of weeks a new document that will be available on our reunification website. And I'll also talk a little bit about other places you can find it. But Kevin, tell us what this thing is and how it came about.
Yeah. Thanks, Audrey. So it's very simply stated, it's an FAQ. It was created, I think, initially based on the really good questions that we were hearing way back when we had our Zoom gatherings before convention, some of the questions we heard during our conventions, and then specifically some of the convocation gatherings that I was involved in here in Bethlehem. And so there's a kind of a consistent theme from location to location that I found of questions that people wanted to hear more about. Some of them we had some ready answers, others the discernment committee is still kind of walking through as they develop models that will be presented at a later time. But there's really a kind of some good questions that are a starting point, I think, for us. In addition to the report that was presented at convention to both of our dioceses, which gives folk this sense of, you know, kind of who we are and where we are.
Super. So your big lay formation training event is this weekend called Gather, and I will be there with you. And that was one of the motivators to get this document together, right?
Yeah. We're trying to kind of, kind of lessen the information void that sometimes exists. You know, the committee's been working on this for 2 years. You and I have been talking about this for almost 3 years, but for many, it's been, you know, the convention and then a few of the Zoom gatherings or convocation gatherings that people have spoken. So we wanted to make sure that we could create a packet at Bethlehem. So it's pretty easy, FAQs. That includes this particular new document and also the original document that I mentioned a moment ago from the convocation, so that we're trying to get people to get to the website, watch the videos, see the report, the initial report, and hopefully it'll bring folk up to speed.
So there are about 15 or so questions, I think, as I look through the FAQ with some pretty substantial answers in them. It's almost like a little booklet, a novella, we might call it.
I like that.
And I noticed as I was thumbing through a draft of it that there are both technical questions around what are we going to do about this situation, and there's also cultural questions or questions that address some of the more affective parts of considering reunification. So, Kevin, I'm going to ask you to talk with me about two of the questions, one a technical question and one more of an affective question. And the technical question is, what about our constitution and canons? What do we do? Hold on, I have to put my glasses on. What about our constitution and canons? Are they similar, or do our dioceses do things very differently? Wouldn't it take years to bring all of this together? So tell us about that.
Yeah, so what we say in the FAQ and what we've been sharing is that there's a subgroup of the discernment committee that's been working, and it's really made up of members of the constitution and canons from each diocese that may be chancellors or assistant chancellors or individuals who just really kind of walk closely. And there are a lot of lawyers in the room on this committee who really have been sifting through both of our constitutions and canons from each of the dioceses. And one of the kind of encouraging pieces from their initial findings is just that there are more similarities than there are differences. They've got a good deal of work together to just kind of walk through that, but we'll have some questions maybe to decide or some models to walk through, peruse about the Constitution and canons. And that may not be one of the most exciting topics, but it's actually really helpful to know that that work is already underway.
Yeah, it might not be the most exciting, but it is. You can't run a diocese without constitution and canon. You can't. It's our rule book. And so yeah. I appreciate all the hard work that's gone into that. And I remember our chancellor saying that there's really only five areas or five items in which we don't necessarily kind of see eye to eye or have the same practices. So we have a meeting set up to talk about those five things, which I think that's great. So the second question, as we think about a more personal side of this, I love this question. It's, how would reunification affect my congregation? We are a small, rural, but vibrant community. And I think that it certainly is a question that I've been hearing in some of our smaller congregations and our bigger ones too. What is this going to mean for me, for my church?
Yeah. And I think one of the things that we're kind of learning early on, or we're wrestling with, is this notion that with reunification, there's a possibility of additional resources, whether they're granting resources or maybe a shifting in assessment that we hope will bring, if we discern to move towards reunification, more resources to the local level. And we know that that's where the good work is happening in our congregations. Some of our smallest congregations are doing some of the most remarkable work. They're renowned in their communities for the work that they're doing, and trying to bring resources to them, we think, is really, really critical.
Yeah. Another piece of that, when we talk about resources, sometimes that can be code for money.
Yeah.
But I think also having a different staffing model, a model where we engage a dispersed staff, which, you know, face it, during COVID, lots of people learn how to work from home. And I think that with a combined diocese, the opportunity for us to have staff in different parts of the diocese, resident, so not everybody has to live in Bethlehem or Harrisburg, that we have several locations. That's another way of getting resources to our congregations in a more local way, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I'm excited about seeing you this weekend, about being at Gather, about premiering this FAQ document. But I also want folks to know that it will be released in our diocese in advance of the convocation meetings that begin for us at the end of this month. And so I'm hoping that everybody who comes to one of our Zoom convocation meetings will have read the FAQ beforehand, so that we can have a deeper discussion than answering all of these questions, which are FAQs, frequently asked questions. So the website, you want to give them the website address, Kevin, for us?
Yes, and it should be up in the next day or two, but it's reunificationdiobeth.org. And if you can't find it there, you can go to both of our websites directly and you'll find it maybe one or two clicks away. But again, reunificationdiobeth.org.
Right. So that'll be available for our convocation meetings in advance. You've already finished your convocation meetings, but now we have Gather. Just before we close, I've picked out a prayer to close with, but I got an email from your assistant today saying, when I introduce you on Saturday, I want you to share, each of you, because you were copied on the email,
yes.
I want each of you to share a fun fact about yourself. So I haven't figured out what I'm going to share Saturday, but I thought maybe we could each share a fun fact right now, just for the fun of it. Do you have one off the top of your head?
Yeah, I had two of them, so I'll share the one I'm not going to share. I was actually kicked out of the chorus in fifth grade. It was, we're both from Connecticut, so I guess in East Granby they may have done it differently than Canton, but basically there was an audition for the fifth grade chorus, and for those of us who did not obviously sing all that well, we ended up making dulcimers. And yes, so I have this constant reminder of the fact that I don't sing very well in my dulcimer. That's my fun fact.
Do you play
You?
dulcimer?
No.
No. Oh, that's a good fun fact. A little sad. Mine is so this is a family story, but I have eight brothers and sisters.
Ooh.
Now, we are a blended family, which these days is kind of typical. But when I was 9 years old, my mom came home and she said that she had some news for me and my two brothers. And the news was that she was going to marry the next door neighbor. I'd
With
never
six
known.
kids.
Well, he had five kids,
Okay.
and then they had one of their own. So
Wow.
there was a movie at that time called Yours, Mine, and Ours. And that we were the living example of that. So I grew up in a household with girls' night and boys' night for washing dishes and all sorts of crazy stuff. It was really fun. That's my fun fact.
Love it.
Okay, I thought one of the traditions in our diocese, in several of our churches, is to pray the prayer of Saint Francis each week. One of our much beloved priests, Pete Greenfield, who now lives with God, he started that tradition, and he's went around to many congregations in the diocese. So it's sort of a home prayer for us. So here
Tribute
we
to him, yeah.
Yeah. Lord, make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, union. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen.
Thank you.
Kevin, great to be with you. I'll see you Saturday. And until then, be well. And the rest of you, may God bless you and guide you and keep you always.